Hello, my name is Patricia McNeely. I'm an Illumined Twin Flame from Chicago, Illinois. And I want to say thanks to all of you for being here on this journey. And I want to start by saying, you are not crazy. I have a lot of people asking me these days, am I crazy? No, thousands of you all over the world cannot be crazy. We're not crazy. Furthermore, we are no longer insane. We're no longer doing the same things and expecting the same results, some of which you see in your communities, some of which you see in the global arena. You're seeing a lot of the same things playing out, trying to do the same solutions. Please know that not only have we busted up systems, there's nothing left propping up the old. A lot of people are going through the motions. Energetically, a lot of you have felt the shift, and it's been a process. This is not a one-time event where we flip a switch and everyone just leaves their body. Or as me and some of my friends have joked around, we've said, you know, we haven't heard from each other. Oh, did you get raptured? Oh, Patricia hasn't put out a recent video. Maybe she got raptured. That's not too many of us. A lot of us have been hit with that thunderbolt or the awakening or a series of awakenings. And this ascension that we're doing is very different in many ways because we're doing it from inside a 3D dense body. We're also doing it from a third density level up, and it's a floating up effect rather than a one-time boom, boom. Now, there are people who will be able to go out of body without dying, and you're getting to that point. Some people are, and there's a distinction to be made between the old fourth dimensional realm of astral traveling, because we've largely concluded that. That's become the place of nightmares, grotesques, playing out things, horror, you know, just thought forms, and it's largely been collapsed. And that's a good thing because the brand new creative space is actually the sixth dimension. So we're going to where we really live in the fifth, and many of you are experiencing your own multidimensionality, and that's a great thing. But some of you are still kind of grasping and getting a handle on that, and it can include glimpses of old memories, past parallel lives. It can include future events and seeing timelines. So what I want to talk to you about today is twin flames, and yes, some of you are getting to the point where you can call yourself a one flame because you're merging. We're embarking in the new. So a lot of you are getting off the train, getting off the ship, getting off the cruise ship where you've been puttering along and trying to bide your time, maintain, and you're finding that you're able to manifest easier. You've met your twin, or your twin has come back somehow, some way, and they're amazingly just seeming like not all their light bulbs are off, or that it's just almost too casual, and you're saying, hey, what gives? Well, what gives is that this is the new. It's up to you to create it. It's also up to you to be patient, to be loving and kind, and continue this and make it new. You're making all of your relationships new, everything. Your relationships with essences, with foods, with organizations, with people, places, things, but mostly with your one true love. This, you've hit the reset button. You're back to center point, a lot of you. Now, we did talk a ways back in a couple of videos back how there's three waves of twins. And there are some people just awakening to themselves as either being a twin. And yes, I've had the distinct pleasure of speaking to some people who are divine counterparts, where their soul has not separated or sustained the soul damage that many twin flames have. They are actually much more of one soul poured into two bodies. So these three waves that are already underway are the Orpheme, that is a lot of the blu-ray Illumined twin flames, and I am myself am a blu-ray Illumined Twin Flame from Source. I'm from the Blu-ray. But we're integrating all the colors of the rainbow. We are becoming our crystal selves again. And so even that identification, it's like saying, well, I was a shaman way back in the Aztec culture. And it's okay if you've identified that. But if you continue identifying with something that's old, you can't move into the new very easily. So it's important to, you know, self-identify as just a sovereign being in the new. The Orpheme, the Ophanim, the Cherubim, and the Seraphim. And all of these angelic lineages carry vibrations that do different things. Doesn't make anyone better than another. But many of you have been through these lineages, and it's like saying, well, I'm an American, but I have the lineage of Kenya and Egypt and Italy and Ireland all mingled in my blood. And a lot of you have been through your own templates, your body templates, throwing out all the pain from those ethnic bodies. You know, keep the good, keep the best, heal the rest, and throw out what doesn't work. You've been doing that, and that's a process, right down to the teeny tiny levels. And I will tell you that all of the work, all of the energy that the universe has been sending you has actually changed your molecular structure. And you're different. You can't hold certain things because you're not intended to house it. Things like anger, rage. You might find certain situations laughable. You might also be triggered because there's a lot of irritations and annoyances. And I'd like to just briefly touch on some of the events that occurred that I mentioned in my last video, global events. A lot of those triggered a lot of sadness and grief out of people. And collectively, particularly for the Blu-rays and what's called 144,000, we now exactly have, we have not the 144,000. It's about 1.1 million people worldwide placed in their grid point ready to merge. And that's the critical mass that's needed to get this going, to fire up the grid. And it's somewhat of a misnomer to say the 144,000, because the 144,000 were originally from Pleiades through Atlantis and so forth. We are having people from all three waves. So there's more of an orchestration than a sequence to it. There's people that have been lined up that are here to support other people for what they're doing. And yes, people do feel previous grid points. What are some of those? Well, some of those have been in Egypt at the pyramids of Giza. It's been in Sedona. It's been in Machu Picchu. Now, if your vibration is really high and you go to those places, you might get there and say, yeah, I don't feel that much. I don't feel the vortices of energy. And that's because you're actually here to plant the brand new energy. You are creating your own grid point. You're one of the ones pulling it in from source and planting it, sending it out through your subatomic structure. So you can't hold things like illnesses, like disease or rages, resentments. It just slides off of you. You can't do it with your twin. And a lot of the things that you know, maybe previously you felt like doing, like smoking, for example, and a lot of you are going to be at the point where you say, I just don't feel like smoking. Why? It's happening from the inside out. Your body is purging out all of the residue and the resins and everything else from, you know, lifetimes of this. So we have these primary, of the three waves, four different angelic lineages. Also, the huge cardinal cross that was started back in last October. We're concluding it. We had a huge push this April. I know a lot of you have been feeling bumpy and like fastening your seatbelts and feeling like you're strapped to the mast of a ship like in a storm since April. April, and then from about July 26th till now. So it's been bumpy for a lot of people, but it's coming, it's concluding for a lot of you in September. And what was this? Well, this was the four cardinal points. This was integrating and balancing with the aspects of fire, the divine masculine and the divine feminine, fiery aspects, the whole entire spectrum of that. Air, water, earth, and you're the love. So, you know, we're getting our moral compasses into place, everything's clicking in, and you're finding that people are acting and behaving differently. People are giving back things that they found or that doesn't belong to them, or they just don't feel like picking that up because they feel someone will come back for it. My brother gave me some things back from childhood that I least expected. I wasn't even missing it, but I knew this is something that, you know, the universe, it's part of that, you know, all things back to their rightful owners. And expect that the person who embodies your heart and soul, that the person that they may be with is going to give them back, because your soul belongs to you. You're the only one it belongs to in the entire universe. That's the only thing that you actually belong to ever, anywhere. I mean, everything material is stuff that we've created. We can collapse it. We can build it new. We can melt it down. We can destruct it. We can use the elements. And that's a thing to note, is that we are in a closed system here. Things are beginning to open up for people, and they're becoming aware of the greater cosmos, of their origins. So you're being ready to enter again into quantum time. And being in the new will mean that there's time compressions. You're going to feel squeezed, pressured. Time will seem like it accelerates, and it already does for a lot of people. I mean, you're supposed to be 24 hours in a day. A lot of you feel like, I'm down to 6 hours. I got 6 hours to get my stuff done. And you have to be able to manage your time appropriately and leave some space there. Leave space for your union, as well as leaving space for the universe to surprise you, because it will, with some really sweet surprises. And you'll also have acceleration. So you have to act and behave as if you're in the new and be ready for it. So a lot of you have gotten through grieving Lemuria, Atlantis, maybe some of the planets that you feel connected to, but that you feel like something's lost, or I left my heart in the Pleiades or something like that. These are all valid feelings, but you're here. Most of you have been already activating your template. You've been scraping off everything that doesn't work. You've been customizing it to yourself. You've been like expanding your body, condensing it. You've been getting good at it. For those of you that, you know, may not know what to do, the important thing is to be able to hold your twin's energies within, where you're pressing them into. They breathe into you. You draw them in. You're going to find that this in and of itself will feel very sexual, and that we're letting go of the old manner of the 3D sexual in favor of a more expansive 5D union sacred sexual, and that everything, every aspect of the masculine and feminine is, yes, in that one person. You've explored everything, so you've taken it out and gotten good at it. Now it's crammed into this other body, and it's up to you to explore each other. And I know what you're saying. You're saying, oh, Patricia, my twin says it's not for this lifetime. Watch yourself. Don't talk yourself out of it. Because why? Behaving and acting as if you're in the new. This is your brand new lifetime right here, right now. Everything else is ancient history. So the importance of continuing to love your twin flame until you become a one flame is requiring you to remain positive, to be imaginative. A lot of you sit there and say, well, I don't know what's happening. And you should be creating. And what I mean by that is, what do you want to do with them? Where do you want to travel? And maybe you don't even want to travel here. Maybe you're like, I got to get back to the Pleiades. I remember what that was like, and we got to get there. Well, the thing is, you're only going to get there when you've merged yourselves together. So that is requiring, you know, a bit of the process being that, yes, you get together again, you merge together again, and it is an ongoing, continuous process. It's happening for a lot of people at night, in their nighttime, in their night visions or travels, in their multidimensionality. And yes, going along the bridge, but actually going to a place, living there, staying there in your brand new light body does require you to be with your twin. So being positive, imaginative, willing, the universe wants your willingness. More than your ideas, it wants your ideas and your imagination, but doesn't want you to use your head to figure it out. It wants you to say, you know what, I don't know how this is going to happen, but I want that person. I want that person, and I know they have my soul, and I love them, love them, love them. I am devoted to them. They are beautiful. Look at them. They're beautiful. They're beautiful. Don't you see? And that's how people see their twins and their divine counterparts. You cannot create the third energy with a soulmate. You just can't. You can't. It is a physical, metaphysical, spiritual, divine impossibility. You can have a great love. You can have a deep love. You can have a bond. You can have tantric sex. But you're not going to create the third energy with anybody but your twin flame. That is why we are so important. Because we are the ones transforming right at the subatomic God particle level. So give your twin fresh starts. Be willing, the willingness of your heart to say, you know, I don't know how this is going to happen. I can't see the details. Guess what? It's new. It's what you create. You know, this is the brand new reset button for almost the entire universe. And while there is guidance, there are people who have ascended and gone before. Right here at this level, it requires you giving a fresh start to your twin. Give them a chance. Give them a fresh start. I don't care what gender they are. There's a lot of dynamics coming up here. And I've had the honor of speaking to quite a few of you. Older women, younger men. Older men, younger women, which might not seem like a news flash. However, when it comes to integrating your soul together, yes, there are things that can come up. People leaving heterosexual marriages because, yes, they are acknowledging that they are here to be with the same gender body, but they are the same soul. So it's the love that's within, but yet the bodies are important because that body has everything you need. All of the keys and treasures are in that body. And yes, there is an importance to gay and lesbian and transgender twins. Many people that I talk to where there's an age difference will say, oh gosh, I don't know, you know, I don't know about this. This person is too beautiful or too this or too that. And guess what? That was your agreement. One of you came in and busted some things up so that your twin could come in and do other things and you could meet each other. You met each other, you activated. Now everything's got to go from your union that doesn't belong. You can't hold and contain this stuff. You're not intended to, you know, drag the entire family with you into your union. It's time to, you know, get people out. Get the organizations out. And it could be with anything. It could be the military. It could be religion. It could be the place to live. It could be family stuff. It could be sexual abuse. It can be a lot of things. So many of you will need to have a talk with your higher self to get a move on. Ask your higher self. Don't ask the archangels. They too have moved on. They've merged themselves and they are themselves living in an ascended manner. They were our guides, yes. It's time for you to call upon your higher self because many of you have integrated enough of yourself. You've also connected back to source. So begin to use your own power. You are the divine feminine. You are the divine masculine. You have everything. Use your magic. Use your power. Ask your own higher self, how do I move on? How do I get out of this situation? How do I get this? Show me, make it so blatantly obvious. And I'm going to say something else about this. When it comes to your twin flame, do not send a mixed message to the universe. Don't send a mixed message. For example, if you're someone who identifies as, you know, your twin is in the same gender body, so that means either gay or lesbian here, and you would say, you know, don't say things like, well, I prefer, and, you know, I'm not sure it's that person, I don't really identify. Be clear about it. Do not send a mixed message to the universe. If you know that person is your twin and you don't know how it's going to come about, that's okay. It's okay to not know the details. You are creating it at other levels. And so that brings you back to the time aspect. When you have a low energy day and you're spirit, your soul is requiring you to lay down, and you're just kind of like, well, I know I'm not getting sick. I know I had this plan. I really wanted to do this or that. I know that there's not anything wrong, but I don't know what I'm doing. I just feel so out of it. I have to lay down. Well, guess what? You are out of it. You're literally out creating, and you're moving, and you're jumping timelines, and you're pulling it in. What I've found for myself is I've been on different cycles. I'll do that, and then 3 days later, it'll happen. And you will feel things like you'll feel like, wait, now go. And you'll feel like, hurry up and go. All of a sudden, it's on. It's like, you got to go take care of this, do that. Why? Because you're creating it on another level, and you've pulled it now into place. And it can be this way with a brand new apartment. It could be with a car. It could be someone coming to the door with something. It could be just an invitation you got. And so this is why you arrange your day to allow for those times when you need to lay down and create. And it's not a head thing, it's a heart thing. You wish for it, the wish of your heart is moving it into place, because you're creating all your brand new relationships, okay? Now, the next thing to talk about is a lot of people who follow energy and astrology and astronomy, because they're very interrelated. The astronomy is the actual physical aspects of those planets. The astrology is the metaphysical or energetic or, you know, energy aspects of it, you know, the nuances of it, you know, what does it mean? And the thing is, you know, much of what's coming up is transformation, take action. Also, the limits of matter. You're integrating spirit into matter, and what are the limits of it? Cut your twin some slack, because cut yourself some slack too, because while you're integrating, and you may not know how to work this, or you might find that one of your gifts is open and you're kind of like, ooh, I know how to do this, or I'm getting this information, and you know, it's all new, and you kind of roll with it. What's happening is that everything that's connected to your star core, so you have your feet, you have your left foot connected to the new, brand new Earth star, you have your star core, which is all of your soul group connections, you have all along your solar plexus here, every single one of your organs, it has a somewhat of a planetary connection. So a lot of you have already integrated aspects of yourself from other places, and you'll feel connected to a planet. But we are right now also integrating aspects of ourselves, a lot still from Sirius, Antares, Aldebaran, Arcturus, Nibiru, and yes, also still the Pleiades. So Sirius and the Pleiades, there's a lot of people here from that lineage. And, you know, okay, UFOs, mumbo-jumbo, stuff like that. Try not to focus on it, because even here it's intended to be entirely new. This is the melting pot, okay? This planet is the melting pot where you're healing, you're getting rid of stuff, you're integrating, you're changing traditions. Don't be afraid to change it up a little bit. Okay? Everything is moving into place for you to be together. So are you trusting or are you doubting? Some of you are understanding that while you're able to manifest a lot of things, you know, foods or invitations or vehicles or rides or travel or whatever, a vacation, what you're not trusting is that you're having a new relationship with your twin, with yourself, that you have new things. Trust that you're going to have new relationships with food. So if wheat bothers you, if dairy bothers you, if meat bothers you, you know, it's possible to have a brand new relationship. The key being that everything in moderation, exercise, you know, all different kinds of things that you're going to have a new relationship, but particularly family, friends, jobs, organizations, you know, everything kind of stems from the love with your twin. You're here together to do this together. You're helping each other. So a lot of you, like, one activated the other, and you're like, woohoo, and you've been waiting around, and now you're waiting, and you're waiting, and you're waiting, and you're grieving, and you're sad, and you're waiting, and then your twins got to integrate all this stuff. Why? We were not stupid. What I mean with that is that when we came through these other places, and when we were in Atlantis, when we were in Lemuria, there were other multidimensional aspects of ourselves. So that is what we are integrating now. We are so magnificent that we only need a part of ourselves here to really get this going. But yes, you need to integrate the rest of your soul here because you're changing it up. And none of this is intended to be a deal breaker for you or your twin. You are intended to be together. And some of the other dynamics with twins that I'll just loosely outline, people whose twin has died, gone to another place to finish up what they're doing, expect them to return to you, especially if you're in a body. Yes, you are creating that, believe it or not. People whose twin that they felt etherically merged with and perhaps they haven't met that person yet, yes, expect that person to show up in a body. Yes. Also, people with twins in the public eye, like a famous twin or a politician or someone who is, you know, somehow either whether locally or maybe they're on the road, they're in front of a lot of people, expect it to shift around because they need you and you need them, but they also need you too. They are getting their messages. A lot of them are doing the grid work for your union, where they're moving around and travel, they're making connections, you know, they're picking up the bits and pieces that are needed. So don't worry about it. You have a plan. If you're in a situation, trust that you have an exit plan. There's an exit plan. Talk to your higher self and say, what's my exit plan? I need to know this. What's fair for everyone? How do I get extricate myself from this situation? Now, as the very last thing I will say, that most important, be the love, balance work and play, have some fun with your ascension. I know I'm a bit of a cornball here, but I've been trying to make this a little bit of fun, and I'm here to encourage you. We're about to turn the corner here, and at that crossroads, but please know, we're not leaving anyone behind. Everyone who's incarnated here can receive the gift of the new light body and everything. Furthermore, we don't really live here. Most of you live in either the fifth or the ninth dimensions, and that's normal and comfortable for you. Now, whether or not you remember, and this is where it comes in, where you say, a lot of people say to me, Patricia, I don't think my twin is getting it really. Like, or what do they know? Well, guess what? Being new means you're not here to really be their guide. You're not here to be their teacher, per se. You're here to be the love and be their partner. And maybe you don't say certain things. You know, maybe they don't resonate with light worker terminology. Some of this we have no vocabulary for. It's been difficult for me to find ways to express things. And Yet it is important to be natural, to have fun with your twin, let it be light. A lot of them are almost like someone who comes out of anesthesia, you know, where they don't quite remember and you might have to repeat things. Be patient. This is your brand new fresh start, and it may not look the way you expected, where it's all hearts and flowers. And why is that? That's because we are the primal force of love. We create the hearts and flowers. We create everything. And this is so, you know, some of this is so silly the way we're manifesting. I had a taste in my mouth earlier of these chocolate candies, and I was thinking, well, I really would like them. At about 4 o'clock yesterday, a young man rang my doorbell, and he was selling boxes of the same candies. And who knows what comes first, the chicken or the egg? Was it the desire of my heart that, you know, brought it right to my door? And yeah, he was selling it. It was a good cause, was to keep some kids off the streets. Remember that the things that you see in the global news arena, you know, there's some stuff playing out now. If you really look back at history, what are the lessons of history? It's not just to not repeat it. It's to get yourself moving out of harm's way. It's to not deplete your resources. And yeah, to know when to fold up your tents and go. I mean, some of these are not our fight. Some of the same things that are happening in one country happened in someone else's country 2 years ago during their revolution. Other people are having revolutions, and I'm an American. Some of the things that my country has done, which I don't personally agree with, is coming to bite us in the butt. You know, it's like, whoa, wait a minute. And it's all playing out. All of the deceptions at the small scale and the large scale, everything's coming out. It's all coming out in the wash. It's coming out. You can't have a war on one end of the earth and not have it raise up a storm on another part. We've had a lot of storms in my country. You know, we're not having a war per se, although in, you know, some neighborhoods are pretty rough, and I live in a big metro city. There's some rough places here. You know, it's been a lot of my personal wish that in my grid point, things are brought to peace, that people actually not only get their needs met, but start to have some flow of abundance. That's my personal wish. Can I go out and fix everything? No. I'm infusing the love here to enable other people who feel it as the passion of their heart to, yes, start that organization or have this drive or to rescue the animals or to clean the environment. And, that's how it is. That's how it's going to begin to look and play out. But the most important thing is, do not become distracted by some of this stuff. Focus on your twin. Focus on your true beloved. When you don't know what to do, hunker down and say, you know what, we're in the new, but what do we need to feel even more new? You know, what's my twin need? What needs healing from the inside? Believe it or not, a lot of you are not doing anything wrong. You're not missing the boat. You are not two ships passing in the night. It's just a process. So patience and the time, knowing when to jump, knowing when you're going to catch that wave and know it's like, woohoo, we're here. We're going through the portal. And, you know, nobody wants to stay in the old, really. Not really. Not really. People are stuck there. But you don't have to be. So thank you so much for listening. I will be covering some of this in much more detail in my next webinar. Thank you to everyone who purchased my webinar. And thanks for hanging in here. Have a wonderful weekend. Bye now.